end of the day, there are going to be stretching vehicle movements on that, in that access, and on the junction of Kenilworth and Gainsborough that in my view would be detrimental to highway safety. Now, I've got, you know, pages of various things that we've refused applications on the grounds of access. Notwithstanding that, you know, it appears that we're quite heterogeneous somehow by not requiring it to be adopted, which in my mind is unusual, particularly if we're talking about social housing and local housing. I guess any affordable housing application to get would normally or always insist that it was adoptable by abstract. And indeed, there's a number of that. I mean, one can understand maybe a private road with one or two houses at the end, but maybe we might not be too worried about adopting or not adopting. The 13 houses we're coming in and say it's not going to be adopted. That would just strikes me that, you know, maybe we're going a little bit too far out of our way to accommodate the development. Given that, in my view, as I say, there will be a highway movement that will be detrimental to highway safety at that access. The other reason just that have been given and pointed out, the unofficial use of green space as proximity to the graveyard, etc. They probably won't pass full step when it came to any sort of appeal situation. But certainly the highway movements in my view was something that if policy was mine, we'd probably hang our hat off for sure. The fact is, at the moment, it is adopted. If it remains adopted, then it doesn't meet our standards. If it's unadopted, that's the point we can wash our hands of it. And I think the conscious decision we've got to make is, do we want to wash our hands of it? Or should we insist to the highways department, don't unadopt it? If it isn't unadopted, then the application cannot succeed under our own highways and their planning policies.
Thank you for that.
I don't see how we can get around it. given the analysis of the access and the fact that most of the, all of the traffic actually will be coming from the southeast, sooner and potentially having some of their south dangerous routes or whatever, which allows you.
Thank you, Stuart. It sounds as though you're looking to move towards refusal for this, so I've asked the officers to consider formal wording. Can we just hear from Paul first, please?
Completely can go with what Councillor Kelly has said so far. I'm rather concerned at what the officer has said, insofar as an officer has decreed that this area should be stopped up and therefore it will be stopped up in any event. Surely the policies of this council are determined by elected members and not officers. This list of perhaps tells us what the policy is.
Okay, I just want to very briefly raise the issue with the VAT survey, because it seems to be an issue with the submission that was referred to earlier from Dr. Ash about, and it seems to conflict in terms of both the quantity and the diversity of bats in the area. I just wonder if you get any clarification on, or are we completely confident in terms of the bat issue in this application at the environment level?
It's been assessed and we've done to object, so the ones not including the report, we didn't object to the bat survey. There is a condition proposed to protect the bats in the new development if it goes ahead and it's approved. And also, it's considered that there are other foraging places to the north of the site in the woodland area. So although the point to be made about impacts of the lights on the insects, it isn't just this site that they forage on, so there is alternative sites that could occur. So, if you could just listen to this suggestion. quite ambiguous about the highway safety issue. But if you look at R05A on the list, so I'll read it out. The local planning authority considers the means of access to the site to be unsatisfactory by virtue of its limited width. The proposal is therefore contrary to policy HS4, in particular criteria 3. Because I think that explains more of a planning reason rather than a highway safety issue. Stuart, are you happy with that proposal?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, do we have a second one? Sure. Okay, Denise. Okay. Okay, all those against the opposition people? Thank you. All those in favour of refusal? The officer's recommendation was to approve, but the committee decided that we will not approve that.
Thank you. Thank you. Residents are experienced in
Lake Road, and the proposal to increase the opening hours to 11 p.m. is not considered to result in any undue noise and disturbance given the existing situation along the main busy street. A noise assessment was submitted and it's been assessed as acceptable, and it's therefore considered that there's no loss of amenity, and the proposal accords with policy HS15 and the National Planning Policy Framework and is recommended for approval. Just before I finish, I'll just make reference to the report. There are a number of conditions that were duplicated from the original permission in 2009, and we're looking at if you might to approve this evening to remove the conditions that are attached at the end of the report. I'll just run through them. And conditions 3-10 inclusive, which relates high-low improvements which have already been carried out, so they're no longer required. And there's condition 17, which relates to materials, the buildings in situ, and is no longer required.
Thank you. Land Reserves Committee. Any comments?
I'll run these stores are going at 11 o'clock. I guess it's expected that we'll be doing maybe more activity. In terms of disturbance, my experience has been different. It tends to be the deliveries that cause most of the tribulation. Having a look at the conditions and comparing them to the conditions of other superstore applications, which are on the agenda indeed tonight, which is not in the fair side of it. Notices that condition 12 allows deliveries and servicing of premises to take place between the hours of 7 and 1 and 10 o'clock at night. Given that, I assume most of these conditions were standard ones for supermarkets. On page 65 of our agenda, which deals with the fair application, the delivery times are set at 8 o'clock to 10 o'clock. Presumably, recommended is 8 o'clock to 10 o'clock. Presumably, having regard to the residential nature of the area, given that we have some residential properties in the vicinity, I wonder about the appropriateness of the delivery times that are not conditioned in what will presumably be new condition number 2. Why the difference we did
The only reason that I can explain is if that's what the applicants put on the application form or given us information that they have the times for particular stores, the times of delivery.
Just to resolve that the only opening times is to 9 o'clock, that the required deliveries to 10 o'clock. So either this is a new condition and we're setting the delivery time at 10 o'clock, or it's wrong in the first place. And if that's the case, why isn't it the same as the other one? Why don't we have some sort of standard that the deliveries are equivalent? I remember the last committee when we discussed deliveries of what we perceive to be acceptable hours, and I'm just wondering, whereas the store face house wants to make it to 11 o'clock, is it appropriate to have a delivery to our market town?
Stuart, that was obviously part of the original application, and
with respect, that's what's confusing, because the original application allowed the store to be open to 9 o'clock. That's what we're seeking to change now. So why in the original application were we allowing deliveries to 10 o'clock if the store was open? Now the law is for 11. I mean, it might just have been that's what the store, that's what we got. And we've never delivered up to 10 o'clock because we've never opened. Now the situation now is where we're likely to approve it open to 11 o'clock, which probably means it's more likely that we get deliveries up to 10 o'clock. Whereas the Rock Ferry application sets the delivery deadline, I just wonder what is appropriate in these circumstances where it's clearly residential purposes and whether indeed you want to take the opportunity to condition.
Thank you, Chair. Again, it's more than likely site specific. that condition. However, there is an opportunity to amend the time of the condition if you so wish.
Take action, but I don't think that it's just I wasn't taking action on the back of this particular application, given that it is an increase in hours in the late hours of the evening and traffic points of view.